You know, there's a lot of debate around how to best tag and version your Docker images, with one side favoring stable tags and the other claiming that unique tags are the way to go. Steve is here to explain the advantages of both sides. Spoiler alert, both are right. It depends on what type of images that you're building, but we'll try to clear it up today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Steve Lasker, and we're talking about Docker containers and the right ways to do things, because you know I will always do it wrong, and then I will call you and you will explain it to me and how to do it right.
And we'll figure out what we missed to get fix it the next time.
We'll fix it together.
Yeah, so this one's just an interesting one. What's the best practice on something that's still evolving? So in this case, this is really kind of based on us working ourselves, and also seeing a lot of customers call us in ACR with a bunch of complaints and help us have us track it down. Mm-hmm. And it turns out a lot of them are they wound up having inconsistent images deployed. And it really kind of came down to what is their tagging strategy? Do you tag with a stable tag using semantic versioning kind of a thing? Or unique tags, which you could also argue is semantic versioning? Or do I skip all that and use the digest so that I'm pinned to a very exact word?
Right.
So we'll kind of pull that apart and figure out where to use each.
Well, and just from an anecdotal, like anecdotes as evidence, nearly every issue that I've ever had with Docker has been my use of tags in some inappropriate way or my misunderstanding of how a tag was used in an upstream thing.
Yeah.
So for a while, the .NET team had tags a certain way, and I would go and say ASP.NET Core SDK build, but I never said the version, so I wasn't explicit. So Monday my build works and Tuesday it breaks, and I shake my fist at them, but it was me because I never really asked for a build that I wanted explicitly. And then other issues was when I was using latest locally, got confused and didn't think about it, and then I ended up just torching my entire Docker images cache and building again.
Yeah, and that's it gets even more confusing when you're local to know whether you're using the local one or the reverse
or
upstream one. So in this case, what we wanted to do is just kind of use an example of some unique and stable tags. And, and actually, the best way for me to show this is some slides, and then I'll do a demo.
Okay.
So here we have three containers that I'm building for this little app that Glenn and I did for the build event last year. And we're doing the Docker builds, and we do Docker pushes. And if we look closely, you'll notice that web colon one, so we have the image and the tag. But it actually points to a digest that's actually the unique identifier for that manifest that represents those images. And the well, that's just important to keep in mind here. So we'll hold on to that for a second.
Is this like labels and SHA-1 hashes in a Git way?
Yeah, actually, it would be a good example of that, right? Because you can have multiple label or the same label pointing to different
ones. Can I move that image tag to a different digest?
Hold that point.
All right.
So I'm going to deploy based on the tag. In this case, I want three copies of web and quotes and four copies of the important thing that we'll deploy.
Okay.
And the orchestrator, and I actually made this more generic than, you know, not trying to be Kubernetes or anything
I appreciate
specific.
The effort made in animations, by the way. Kudos.
Thank you. I'm a visual person.
No, it
this
works.
The way I
it
think.
Absolutely helps me understand.
So anyway, so that thing's deployed, and Kubernetes, and or the orchestrator in this case, said, hey, I'm going to distribute these and keep them running. And life's good. And it's going to keep them running because it stores it in its little DB there that says, hey, I need to keep these things running. That's its job. So now somebody else is working, and they're doing builds, and they didn't bother changing the tag. So they did a build of some random change that they made, and it went into the registry with one.
Okay.
And this could be intentional or accidental. It doesn't really matter. But notice now, to your point, those tags, the quotes one and important one, are pointing at different digests now.
Uh-oh. I see where this is going to go sour.
So here, now, what we're going to do, we're going to kind of get rid of one of those nodes. And the orchestrator is going to go, whoa, my job is to keep so many copies of these things running. I'm going to redeploy using the tag that I was told.
And host A is still running.
And now, as you've guessed, you now have this inconsistency here that you have the same web one and other, quotes and important one running, but they're different versions.
Which is exactly the thing that they promised me orchestration and containers were not going to cause, right? The whole point was magic.
Well, so this is what I love, or as with all these, right? You got to be careful, because a hammer can be really good until you smash your thumb. Mm-hmm. Then you blame the hammer. So the orchestrator was doing its job.
Right.
That's the thing here is the orchestrators, and this is what I love around this whole infrastructure of containers, is orchestrators are finally taking the fact that hardware will fail as a premise.
Right.
So its job is to run it again. So how do we get out of all of this? And we'll take this example. So I actually have the site running here.
Okay.
And you can see that there are two containers running.
Yep. You're hitting refresh with your hotkey here, yes. And I see the host name swapping between two.
All right. And if we come over here.
That's up in
here,
Kubernetes somewhere.
And we look at our deployments, we'll notice that we have, for Hello World, we have two containers running.
Makes sense.
And pods, of course, we'll see two. And we'll now quickly fix and break this.
All right.
So we're going to come over here, and we're going to say, instead of grabbing the color from the environment variable, because that was really risky, we're just going to hard code it. And we're going to say, we'll use purple again, because that was pretty obvious that it stood out in that other one. So now, if I come over here, and we say AZACR build.
Right, so this is your build again.
We're going to build it, and we have our tag. In fact, this case, we don't. I'm sorry. I have to take that back. What I want to do here is use the exact tag. So let me clean this up a little bit.
So you're going to put a new purple build at the tag that is already being used by Kubernetes.
Exactly. So let's come over here, and we'll look
at
our
pod. With
only
the best of intentions.
Nothing. What could go wrong? So we'll come over here, and we've got
AAHM.
Right. So HM and dot.
So new code, reused tag.
So I like stable tags, right? I'm not actually changing, you know, my deployment per se. I'm doing this little minor bug fix. I shouldn't have to rev the whole system.
Right.
Well, we'll see what happens here. So we'll build that, and we'll actually have to give that a second, because what I want to do is go and kill off one of those nodes. Mm-hmm. And when you kill a node, just like we did in the animation, you know, what's it going to do? It's got to go back and pull another image, because the cluster itself doesn't actually keep images.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The cluster says, my job is to pull images.
Pulls images, right.
And goes and deploys them. So we're almost done there.
Okay.
And
so in this case, the orchestrator is doing what it should be doing. And this, I'm starting to realize what best practice must be, because you've changed something that was pointed to by something, like you dereferenced a pointer.
Right. Exactly. So that's why it's really important to understand, you know, the tech. And this is why I feel a little more comfortable in this one. Mm. You know, and since we've been doing this, and since we posted the blog post on the whole thing, we've actually had a lot of reduction in calls.
And this isn't an Azure-specific thing. This is just a containers as we as a community start to understand better.
Exactly.
The role of the orchestrator, the role of the container registry.
So if we look, we should have, here we go, here's the pods. So we've got a couple of pods running here. Actually, you know what I'll do? I'll go back and to our deployment.
We're
just going to scale it. We'll actually do the nice thing. We're not going to kick it in the
head. So rather than hurting one of them on purpose, you're going to add another, and that new one will be pulling from a new location.
Because nobody should have a failure anyway, so
Indeed.
Why would it matter? So now we've got the third one coming in, and if we refresh this, it's not going to work because our connection died. Hold on. I was afraid of that. So no problem. We'll just reestablish the SSH connection.
The tunnel that you were using, your local host Kubernetes is a tunnel off to the Kubernetes in the cloud.
Notice it says 127
there
up here.
Go.
So we'll come over here. There's our two hello worlds. And actually, because it misbehaved, I am going to kill one and we'll shoot it in the head. But notice it's doing its job.
So
it was
hurt one while another one's coming in. So we've got a failure and a scale out simultaneous.
Well, it didn't get this. It might have.
It got
no,
it.
Well, that's three the third one trying, and it's going to.
Three out of
roll
two.
Out? I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll get
but
something.
Either way, as we come here, we'll see this.
Oh.
So I'm just refreshing.
Okay.
And
now this is just purple, but it could be a tax thing or a number thing or some fundamental business logic. And this is why sometimes we get DVDs at a discount and sometimes we don't, because somebody rolled it out wrong in the product.
Exactly.
Product catalog.
So that right there is really the crux of the the thing. And if we come back here, what we want to be able to do is just recap on our tagging techniques.
Okay.
So stable tags, perfect, right? If you look at my base image over here on the Docker file, you'll notice that I've got base image node 9, right? So when I want to use, I want to bind to 9 versus 10, 11, or 7, or whatever, when the community ships an update to node 9, I want to get that.
Like a fix, a non-breaking change.
A non-breaking OS patch, you know,
security,
a runtime patch, some kind of security issue that should not change the behavior.
A revision rather than a version.
So that's where stable tags are perfect, right? I want to have my from statements on stable tags because I want to get those OS and framework patchings. When I'm deploying, I always want to deploy unique tags. So stable tags, the way you can manage those is, let's say that some framework is shipping, you know, 1.0. And that's fine. It points, the latest and one will point to that. And you'll notice that I could also have additional tags. So what I'm saying here is one actually points to 1.2 at this point.
Right.
And latest, you know, in this case, is always rolling forward as well. Here, I actually want to have a 2.0. So now I could have a stable one that actually points to 1.2.
Right.
And two is a new band. So 2 points to 2.0.
So are you recommending both a major and minor tag to be explicit and then allow the floating of those?
That's kind of the subtlety. This is where I'm kind of leaving it, because the people that are doing this kind of tagging should be the framework providers, right? It's whether it's somebody at a company building a framework or you know, us building ones and shipping them. So you can kind of see that you really can get both going on there.
Okay.
Serviceable tags are also that kind of model. If we notice, we're moving the tag forward, including 1.1.
Right.
Here we're saying 1.1 has an OS patch or a framework patch or something upstream.
Right.
So we actually even moved 1.1 forward. So that's all what I'm trying to show here is you can still use these moving forward. And that's the whole idea, because each one of these are going to trigger or should be triggering downstream teams.
So then how would I prevent the purple issue that we just saw happen? I would prevent that by A, not reusing a tag during a push.
So that's this one. So this one, the top one is are the framework teams. Here, every tag's something new, right? So that's what we want to do deployments. And just as a summary there, the base images for from statements, use stable tags, and deployed images, I want to use run and, you know, like Helm update and so forth.
So I'm hearing I need to be conscious about my underlying frameworks, what's going to be stable, realize that what I say explicitly is what's going to happen. So
be
conscious.
Like, you don't want to use latest on anything other than a demo because that's always going to be floating and that's not necessarily stable. A stable tag is more of the 1.0, right? 2.0, those kind of things. But if you also noticed in the serviceable tags, if I bound to the digest, which is totally valid you know, from a technology, if I'm bound to 91EFJ6, when that framework or OS ships an update, I'm not getting it.
I'm not going to see it. It's going to happen, and I'll never know.
And you'll never know, and somebody's going to figure it out, and now you're exploited, and the world ends as we know it. The here's just a bunch of info, you know, that you can check out more things on, and I hope people will.
Fantastic. Well, I appreciate you putting together this resource, because I feel like with a combination of hard work and animations, as well as a very visceral demo that shows that this can easily happen in production if you're just not thinking, reminds me that computers do exactly what you tell them to do.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm learning all about best practices in Docker tagging in my images here on Azure Friday.